Hello students, welcome to your dance club and your first online class. I hope you all are doing well. Some of you are new to the club, yes, and some of you are old, you've been with me for some time. So for the new ones, I am Shirisha, your dance teacher, and we shall be learning forms such as ballet, contemporary and jazz in the clubs, alright? This is a great way of me being able to connect with you and bring activities and dance classes, or everyone for that matter, whoever is being able to do this for you. Yes, we are really grateful that we are being able to do this for you, and I hope you all are also going to take it in the same stride and you're going to use these classes, yeah, to your benefit. With that, I want you to make sure that you're not doing anything at the risk of injuring yourself or creating nuisance. Yes, so make sure at home, whichever space you find to dance and work out, you make sure that there are no objects that you can injure you in the process, all right? Or you can injure someone while you're dancing. So be careful of all of these things, because now you're going to have restricted space. Yes, but we all have discussed space and dancing in school, right? So those are the same principles you have to apply here also. You have to be aware of your surroundings, how you're moving, how much you're moving. Probably if you do not have the space to kick your leg out like that, then don't kick it so high. Probably kick it a little bit low, yes? So be smart with how you move, and yet use the full potential of your body, okay? So if I probably kick side like this, and I go so high, maybe I can, but you cannot. So you can still kick nicely with a full straight sharp leg, but a little bit lower, and it looks just as nice, yes? So we need to use our brains wisely. Also, doesn't mean that if you probably cannot kick high, do these kind of things, you will not work on your flexibility. You will work on your flexibility, okay? Do your warm-up properly. Work on your flexibility to its fullest so that when you come to school, you can use that. Right now is the time to work on these little things that you keep telling me in class, that ma'am, I cannot work on my flexibility as often, I cannot work on my strength as often, or I cannot work on my dance moves as often because I have this and that. And now there's no traveling to school, yeah? So all of that extra time, no traveling to tuition classes, everything is being done at home. You have all this extra time. So use it for your benefit. Every morning, every evening, take out 10-15 minutes for yourself and work out, yes? So we are going to learn certain workout exercises today in the class. I would like you all to apply those as often as you can. Maybe if you cannot do it every day, then do it on an alternative day. That's also good. But start somewhere and then build. All right? Fine. So now moving on to the class. Okay? What we are going to learn today are certain warm-up exercises that you can do before every online class that you receive. So first you should do that warm-up and only then move on to the next class. Okay? So whatever warm-up you are going to learn now, you should use this and then move on to the next class. Theek hai? Alright. I will try to talk on top of the music so that you can hear me loud and clear. Okay? But be attentive to everything that I'm saying, and I will be showing everything. Even if you cannot hear something here and there, make sure you're looking at me with full attention and focus so that you understand every position nicely. Okay? Do not harm yourself, enjoy yourself, listen to the instructions all the way more carefully, because now I'm not there to correct you. You are there to correct yourself, yes? And we can be the best teachers for ourselves if we want to be, yes? So listen to everything I say and then apply it in your body. You will be able to have more awareness and more understanding of your own body if you apply everything by yourself. Okay, and you be careful to every detail. Come, let's start. The first thing that we're going to do is we are going to warm up with circles. So everything, all our body parts are going to move in circles. Yes, everything is going to move in circles. So whatever I'm moving right now is going to go in circles. I'm going to use counts of 4 or 8. We are going to go sometimes slow, sometimes fast, but I'm not going to stop in between, okay? I'm going to play some music and then you all will keep following me with the music, alright? So we are going to start. Open your legs out and keep your hands on your waist. Yes, keep your legs relaxed, your knees relaxed, your shoulders open, your neck relaxed, yes? And then we start with the music. But they're wide, they're not like this. Yes, this is closed position. We are trying to stay open. So open your legs and open your feet also a little bit with it. Yes, so you're going to make sure that your feet are pointing slightly to the corner of the room. If you're facing a wall, then it's your feet are facing the corner. Okay, so you're going to stand like this. In this process, you have to make sure that you don't end up pushing your hip too far out, yes? Because When you stand like this, sometimes if you're not so flexible, you might end up doing this. Yes, you might be a little tight in your flexors and this might happen. So you need to correct this, okay? Sometimes you also have the habit, even if you're flexible, we have the habit of standing like this. Yes, which is wrong. You're kind of pushing your hip too far out, unknowingly maybe, but you're pushing it too far out. And that is why you're straining your hip flexors, which are becoming shorter, and your back is also kind of becoming shorter because it's squeezed, yes? So you need to make sure that you tuck this tailbone in its place, yes? Do not let it stay out like this. Let it relax, yeah? I always give an example of like a pendulum. Some of you know what a pendulum is, some of you don't. So just imagine a big rock, okay, which is hanging by a thread. So if you hang a rock by a thread like this, what will happen? Will it be here? Will it be here? Will it be there? Will it be here? No. If a rock is hanging by a thread and I don't move my hand at all, it's absolutely stable, it's going to hang absolutely straight. Yes? It's not going to be out there, 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 or here. Yes? So you need to make sure that your tailbone acts as that rock. Yes? And the rest of your spine is that thread. You need to make sure that it is relaxed completely. There's a natural curve in our spine, which is okay. So standing like this is fine, but standing like this is not fine, okay? Or standing like this is not fine. That is also wrong. So you need to make sure that your body is just relaxed and comfortable, okay? Now my feet are also slightly turned out. There is one more thing that you're going to need to know when you do this. We are going to bend our knees in this position. But it is very important when you bend the knees, you bend it right over your toes, okay? So you need to make sure that each of your knee is going right over your toes. And they're not doing this or they're not doing that. Yeah, that's absolutely wrong and bad for your knees. So make sure when you bend every time, you're opening your knees, which is going to happen from your thighs, yeah? You need to make sure you open your thighs and you keep your tailbone in the right place. If you don't do that, if you do that, then also your knees can kind of pull in. And if you do this, then also your knees can kind of push forward like that, yeah? Both of them are going to ruin your knees. It's going to hurt your knees, not in a good way. That is not going to be a good pain. That is a bad pain, okay? So you need to make sure that you go down in a way where your knees are over your toes, yes? Now, we are going to do the exercise, yeah? So try to follow with me whatever I do through the exercise with music. Come.
Yeah.
that was some hard work on your hips. But yes, if you do this correctly, you're going to immediately feel a lot warmer in your hips, yes? A lot of flexibility comes from here. And a lot of strength comes from here, okay? A lot of flexibility is going to come from your groin muscles. And a lot of strength comes from your gluteus, which is your hip muscles, basically. Yeah, your your upper thighs and your hip, yes? So a lot of it is coming from here. You need to make sure that your hips are strong and your groin is open. How is that going to happen? This particular exercise is the best way to do it. It strengthens your glutes because it squeezes the glutes while it opens your groin muscles, yes? So if you do it correctly, this is going to make you feel really flexible. Fine. Okay, so this was the second exercise. Now we are going to do the last warm-up exercise for today, which is a roll down. Okay, we are going to do 3 to 4 sets of it, and you can do it probably even 8 times to just get the feel of it. Okay, fine. Roll down. Just think of what the name suggests. It suggests of something rolling downwards. Yes, something rolling downwards. Yes. Now, what is this thing that is rolling downwards? It's basically your body, your whole body. You're going to imagine your body is like a yoga mat. Okay, you've all seen yoga mats. Now you're going to imagine your body to be one. Okay, you see how we start rolling the mat from one end, and then as you keep rolling, 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 you reach the other end and the mat is completely folded. Our bodies are kind of like that, but not completely like that. So we are going to apply this principle with knowing that our body works in a slightly different manner. So you need to be able to understand it both ways, okay? Your upper body is something that can roll forward and backward. Yes, you know that? You have this flexibility of going forward and backward because your spine has movement towards all sides, right? Forward and back and side to side. Yes? But your legs, can your legs bend forward? Like, can you push your knees backwards and roll your legs forward? You can't do it, I'm telling you. Okay, don't try. Because if you do that, then you're going to break your knees and break your legs. Because in the spine, you have like joints after every little bone. Yes, that's different from your legs. Now, what happens is you cannot roll your legs forward. And so, what you can maximum do for the legs are keep them absolutely straight. Yes? So when you do a roll down, you're going to make sure that your legs are absolutely straight. Whereas your spine does the rolling action of a mat. And your hands and your head help you reach to the other end of your body. Understood? So we are going to start from the top end. Okay, what we're going to do is the first end is going to roll, and that is how you're going to do it. You're going to tuck your chin into your chest, then this keeps rolling, 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 rolling. And you see how my spine is curving forward? You allow it to curve forward and let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go, and let it allow it to go from your lower back also and relax as much as you possibly can. Yes. If you can reach the floor, you touch the floor. You see also my legs are absolutely straight. Do you see that? My upper body is kind of relaxed and a little curved. It's relaxed and a little curved. Yes, I'm going to relax my head here also. Now, if you probably cannot reach the floor and you only reach till here, no problems at all. You stay there and you breathe, okay? And make sure you're trying to go from your low back lower and lower and lower without jerky motions. This jerky motion, this is a no. It's a complete no, okay? What you can do is to go forward and help yourself. Breathe in, breathe out, and with every exhalation of the breath, you allow your body to go a little bit more down. Yes, You feel it. You feel the breath going into your legs and then releasing all the tension in your body, and you release it out with experiencing that little bit more of flexibility that you've just generated in your body. And it could be just this much, yes? And even if it's just that much, it's absolutely fine. Because slowly, slowly, if you keep doing it, it's going to help you reach the floor one fine day, okay? If you can reach the floor, you can also bend your elbows and try to go deeper. There is no stopping to this, okay? Try to touch your head to your ankles, your shin, wherever you can possibly. And just stay there, yes? This is how you do a roll down. You see, my legs are absolutely straight all the way through. Now, how do you get out of a roll down? You are going to bend your knees, yes, and act like you're sitting on a chair. So you're going to push this tailbone that we were talking about, the same rock, into the chair, and you will allow the rest of your spine to unfold. Your head was the first thing to go up. It's the top end, so it's the last thing to open up. Yes, not before. Do not do this. That is not what we are learning right now. We are here and we are going to make sure that the head is the last thing to come up and the knees are even later than the head to straighten out. Understood? Very important point. Yeah, so your head is the last thing to roll out and your knees straighten out even after that. Okay? Now, I hope you've understood this. If you haven't, you can go back and view the whole thing again and understand it one more time. Or, if you're ready, we're going to start right now and we're going to do this a couple of times with music. You can repeat this a couple of times to build good flexibility for yourself, okay? Now, the last thing that we are going to do today are called squats, okay? So, this is basically again a warm-up for you all and also a strengthening exercise. So, what I need you to do with me right now is, like how we talked about bending our knees, it's going to use the same principle. What we are going to do is, we are going to make sure that as much as our body can stay absolutely straight, will stay straight. That is our upper body basically. And the lower body is going to bend. But we're going to make sure that our knees don't go in front of our toes, okay? That is going to be a wrong thing to do. So you need to make sure that when you go, you push your hip back, yes? And you try to keep your back as straight as possible and keep your knees on top of your toes or behind your toes. And then, you go down as low as you can without doing this, yeah? Do not relax into it. I don't want you to relax. It's an active squat. You stay here, you make sure your legs are working. Don't sit into it. That's wrong. So you're going to stay active and then you're going to look slightly up. Yes, you find a point up and you keep looking towards that point and then you slowly come up and squeeze your hips. Yes, when you come up. Now you're going to go down again, squeezing. Make sure that your stomach is tight when you go down. Apply all the posture that you've learned in earlier classes, okay? And you're going to go down. Make sure your shoulders are open, your hips are nice and square. And you go down and you keep looking up. Yes? From there, we're going to push from our hips and squeeze them to close. Yes? So we are going to do 3 sets and 10 repetition in each set. Okay, and then we are going to hold the squat. Okay, this is our last workout for the day, so do it well. Okay, you need to make sure your legs are right under your hips and your shoulders. Okay, so this is how you stand. Then you can relax your toes a little bit, stay in a natural turnout. Okay, don't do that wrong, absolutely, just a little bit so that you're natural and comfortable. And then you start doing the squat. Okay. So when you start doing it, you remember how we discussed right now what all you're supposed to maintain. You maintain all of that, you do the squat and you come up to squeeze. Make sure this is a nice and grounded base that you're giving yourself. Okay?
Soft lips, yeah, you know word of mouth. The square root of 69 is 8 something, right? Cause I've been trying to work it out. Good white wine, I come alive in the nighttime.
You all should be feeling warm now. If you probably feel that you can do more, okay, right now you feel energetic and you feel pumped up, then you can try a few stretches, because now you're nice and warm. You can probably like go into a split. The ones who can do a split can go into a split. Who cannot and have been practicing with me can practice lunges, yes. So practice all these if you can. If you don't know all of this right now, I'm going to just recommend you to do a few more roll downs to help loosen out the back of your thighs. Yes, the roll downs that we did, you do those so that it can help you loosen out the back of your thighs. And then slowly all these advanced stretches I will incorporate in the classes and you will get to know how to do them. Right now, only try Be responsible, okay? This is the only thing I ask from you all. Be responsible and only do the things that you can. And try the ones that you cannot, but with full dedication, focus and responsibility. Do not just do anything, okay? Be careful with it. Okay, thank you guys. I'm going to see you all next class. Hope you all stay safe and stay happy and rejuvenated. Much love. Bye-bye.